In this video, we will be looking at three fundamental ideas in linear algebra: the idea of linear combinations, span, and linear independence. Okay. The idea of linear combinations we will use multiple times through the rest of the course. You can even think of these as simple definitions, but they are very, very powerful ideas when you do a full linear algebra course, or if you have done a full linear algebra course. In fact, a lot of power of linear algebra comes from these three ideas. So, the idea of linear combination is simple. So, let us say you have a set of vectors v1, v2, vn. So, remember I have shown this in bold, which means each of these is a vector. Okay. So, suppose v1 through vn is a set of vectors. What you can get by combining each one of them through a linear combination is simply some coefficient multiplying this plus some other coefficient multiplying this. So, some scalar coefficient multiplying each of these vectors and adding them is called a linear combination. It is a very intuitive kind of definition. Okay. So, mathematically you would write it as alpha 1 v1 vector plus alpha 2 v2 vector, so on and so forth up till alpha n vn vector, where alpha 1, alpha 2, etcetera are different scalars. So, let us take a simple example. So, let us say v1 is the vector 1, 2, 3, v2 is the vector 2, 0, 3, and v1 plus 2, v2 for example is a linear combination. Okay. In this case, we get 5, 2, 9. Okay. Now, an interesting way of thinking about this linear combination, v3 remember was v1 plus 2 v2, is to write it as a product. Okay. So, we can write it as v1 v2 multiplying 1 2, so that you get v1 plus 2 v2. Okay. So, in matrix notation you can write it as this vector which was v1, this vector which was v2. Now, if you multiply this vector by this, you will notice that the first element is 1 plus 2 times 2, 5. 2 plus 0 times 2, 2, 3 plus 3 times 2, which is 9. Okay. So, essentially v1 plus 2 v2 can be thought of a linear combination of two columns, v1 as first column, v2 as the second column. Okay. So, this is a tremendously useful way of thinking of things. Okay. So, matrix multiplication, when you take one matrix and multiply it by the other matrix, it can actually be thought of as a linear combination of columns. Okay. So, for example, if you have this matrix once again 1, 2, 3, 2, 0, 3, and I multiply it by a matrix 1, 3, 2, 4. Okay. So, this is basically the first column of A, the second column of A. Okay. So, now what you can think of, you will notice that 5, 2, 9 is exactly what we had here. Why? Because it is a linear combination of v1 to v2. Now, what will be this column? This column essentially is 3v1 plus 4v2. Okay. So, the result of matrix multiplication, each of the columns of matrix multiplication can actually be thought of as some particular linear combination of the columns of the matrix V that we are multiplying with. Okay. So, we will utilize this idea when we come to the idea of invertibility, etcetera. Okay. The second idea that we want to discuss in this video is the idea of span. It is a natural outgrowth of the idea of linear combination. The span of a vector, okay, or a set of vectors is whatever you will get, okay, by every possible linear combination. So, remember in the last case, last video, or sorry, last slide, we had a simple linear combination v1 plus 2 v2. But suppose you let alpha 1 and alpha 2 free and you try and find out every possible linear combination, okay, of that, that is called a span. This should become a little bit clear if we look at an example. Okay, so, let us say we are looking at two vectors, v1 is 1 0 and v2 is 0 1. What would be the span of this thing? Okay. So, mathematically what is going to be the case? Let us just look at it geometrically and then we can see quickly mathematically what happens. So, v1 remember or notice is simply the unit vector in the x direction, v2 is the unit vector in the y direction. Any vector that you have, okay, so let us say you have a vector v1, alpha 1, alpha 2, all alpha 1, alpha 2 is alpha 1 v1 plus alpha 2 v2 okay, because alpha 1 times 1 0 is going to be alpha 1 0 and alpha 2 times v2 is going to be 0 alpha 2. So, you can add these two and get any vector. What it means is the span of the coordinate vectors is the whole of 2-dimensional space, a whole of R2. Any vector that I choose can always be written as a linear combination of these two vectors. Okay. So, the span of these two vectors is going to be the whole of the coordinate space R2. Okay. Similarly, you can think of, you know, multiple things. For 3D, if you define 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 and 1 0 0, if you define these three vectors, their span will be the whole of 3D space. Okay. The span of all columns of a matrix is called the column space. Okay. So, if I have some matrix, once again I will take the same example as last time, all the vectors that you will get of the form alpha 1 times 1 2 3 plus alpha 2 times 2 0 3. For all alpha 1 and alpha 2, this will be the span of these two vectors. Okay. Now, notice that if I have an equation Ax equal to b, what it means is I have some matrix A, I have some vector x, and I am obtaining some other vector b. So, suppose I give you an A and I give you a B and I ask you to find out x. If this equation has a solution, it automatically means that B has to be in the column space of A. Why is that? We just saw this in the previous slide. This vector is simply the linear combination of first vector multiplied by x1, second vector multiplied by x2, third vector multiplied by x3 and nth vector multiplied by xn. It automatically means that B is in the column space of A. The final idea in this video is that of linear independence. A set of vectors is defined to be linearly independent if none of these vectors can be written as a linear combination of the other vectors. Okay. These three ideas of linear independence, linear combination and span are actually very, very deeply related. Unfortunately, we would not have the time to go through all the interrelations between them. You can treat them as three sort of related ideas. Okay. I think some of you might be able to automatically see the correlations between these ideas. So, in this, all we are looking at is if I have a set of vectors and let us say I take these two vectors 1 0 and 0 1, you cannot write v2 as a linear combination or as any linear multiple of v1. Okay. Now, suppose I take these three vectors 1 0, 0 1 and 3 4. Now, these are not linearly independent, I would call it linearly dependent. Why is that? Because v3 is 3 v1 plus 4 v2. Okay. So, since v3 can be written as a linear combination of the other two vectors, these three vectors are not linearly independent. So, mathematically we say that any set v1 through vn is linearly independent if and only if, okay, the linear combination alpha 1 v1 plus alpha 2 v2 up till alpha k vk for any k is 0, automatically implies that there is only one possibility. Notice that if I set alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha k equal to 0, obviously I am going to get 0. Okay. But that should be the only solution to this system of equations. Why is that? Okay, notice here, if v3 is equal to 3v1 plus 4v2, it automatically means v3 minus 3v1 minus 4v2 equal to 0. In this form, I can write it as minus 3v1 minus 4v2 plus v3 equal to 0. So, I will check V1, V2, V3, I find out some linear combination, alpha 1 is minus 3, alpha 2 is minus 4, alpha 3 is 1, which gives me this equation equal to 0 without all the alpha I being 0. If that is the case, then the set of equations is linearly dependent, and if the only solution to this system of equations is that alpha 1 through alpha k is fully 0, then that means that the set of vectors is linearly independent. Thank you.